Then what is Azure? So the Azure is your cloud-based offering from Microsoft that organization can use to manage their or move to manage their to move or manage their infrastructure services. This is open and flexible cloud platform. It is open, flexible. You can simply move it at any point of time. You can just see what is the compatibility with respect to all the different languages they are offering, different operating system they are offering, different services they are offering. You can adapt any one of it. You can build, deploy and manage your application across global network. They have a data center which is spread across the globe, and you can use it wherever you want to. You can use it where you want to deploy and build. So you can simply use this global data center and access it. Then you can also build your application using any language, tool or framework. You can also integrate your public cloud application with your existing IT environment. So assume you want that your primary data center must be, your primary application must be in your in-premises data center, but the DR you want to build on your cloud. You can do that. We just talk about the cloud busting. So that feature is also available from the Azure. This Azure basically runs in a region. A region is, if you just look for this graph, you can see this, the blue one is basically, green one, sorry, I can say that, is basically showing which is the existing one. This is the existing regional where Microsoft Azure is already present. If I talk about the India, India is there present in Mumbai, Pune and Chennai. And then all the other regions you can see it. The blue one which is shown into the triangle, it is the coming location, upcoming locations. This is based on 15th December, which is last day's status. So the Azure region is nothing, but Azure region is basically your data centers located around the globe so that you can adapt or use based on your business requirement. So in simple word, what they have did, they have created a, they have divided the world into the different region, like Europe is a region, America is a region, Asia is a region, India is a region. And every region, they have their presence. They have their own resources, which you can use it. So assume you are based out of India, your business is based out of India, and you want to use the cloud services. The best one, you can go ahead and use it from the India only. Why you should go for Singapore or other one else? But if you are based out of Singapore, you should not supposed to access the, your resources from the India. Instead, you can you go ahead and use it from the, or host your application into the nearest location, which may be a Singapore, right? So this data centers, which is they are located into this geographical region, is known as the Azure regions. They've created in such a way that one region should be a distance enough. From one region to another region, we have a sufficient distance. So if one region can impact it, other region should not. Assume one region have an impact due to a cyclone, earthquake, maybe some due to a tsunami, whatever, then it should not impact the other region. So when you talk about the Azure, it is a public cloud, and the minute they talk about the region, it is the locations where they have their own data center or are public. Specific, they have some cloud or some region which is dedicated to the government, especially for the US government. So they have a some regional cloud. They have cloud which is probably in one of the region, US, which is specific to the government one. But again, there's a fall for the all the government. So they ensure that their data center must be in different region so that if one is impacted, you can able to access your services from the other one. So when you want to choose the location where you can host your services, you can use it based on your location. Where is your business located? We just talk about it. And in case you have a business is across the globe or the different region, then you can look for the, assume it is operated from across the India, then you can look for the probably Mumbai region, or your business across the Asia Pacific, probably you can look for the Singapore region. But you need to always ensure that what is the nearest location which you can use it for host your services. Let's talk about the compliance. With respect to compliance, if they have some specific compliance need, probably they are your organization say that you cannot use any services or one of the compliance that you cannot use any services which is outside of the India, probably then you can look for the India region, or you can look for based on the compliance, you can look for that region. Service availability, remember all the services which is like, because as you're offering your number of services, not necessarily the all the services are offered on the all the region, because region is each region have a data center and they need to offer their services from their respective data centers. It's not necessary the all the services may be available from all the region. Maybe few services are not available from that region which you are looking for. In such a cases, you should always rule and see whether all the services are available from the region where you, which you want to look for it. Then probably we have another one is with respect to data sovereignty and residency. Probably if I just want to take an example, probably let's take a use case of Aadhaar. The government of India says that your Aadhaar data should not be go out of your Indian boundary. In such a cases, you can't use any location or the services where you are expecting your data can be replicated out of the your country boundary. So you can also look for that reason to choose which is the best location you can go and opt it. And again, and the last one is with respect to pricing. It is also a chances that one of the region for the same services, one region can charge you some X amount, maybe another region may charge you some X plus one amount. So there's a pricing may be a different from one region to another region. So you can also look for the pricing. So all which one is getting cheaper so that you can opt it. Remember when you decide it at the time of when you're planning your migration or you're planning for hosting the services, you can look all these options to decide which region you can go ahead and do it, because so that you can start building your servers or your infrastructure on that region. Okay, now another concept is known as Azure region pair. So what happened? Assume this is one of the region and which this region maybe have a, you have a servers. Let's say this region may be in India. I'm just taking an example. India, Mumbai region. Let's say that. Then what they have did, they have paired this region with another region, maybe a let's say Chennai region. They have created a pair. So they can consider this two region as a logical location. The purpose of this region is if you can host your one of the service, say you created a server and your server may be in India region, Mumbai region, and you created another server which is your backup server in a Chennai region. If there is any disaster happened to one of the region, probably you are still able to access your services from the another region. That means we talk about the region pair. So the region pair, it means a region pair as your say that region pair is an area within a geography. Remember, within a geography. That's why I'm saying Mumbai and Chennai, which is containing one of the or two more data center. Probably if you just take this example, I have a one data center into the region, another data center into the region, should be into the regional pair, part of the same geography. So what happened? Such if I have a one instance in Mumbai region, another one in Chennai, it has to be replicated each other. If one of the region goes down, you're still able to access your services from the another region, which is fall under the same region pairs. If I look for the benefit, let's say that I have a few important thing, which is like compute. I have a primary region, I have a secondary region. I have a compute, which is virtual machine running into the primary secondary, which is a replicated. Then I have a storage. I have a primary account, I have a secondary account. What is this account? We talk about when we'll discuss about the storage module. But assume that you have a two different account and both are replicated to each other. I have also a primary secondary databases is also replicating to another region. So these all services are actually replicating. So in case your this particular region is not available, you are still able to access your all services from this region pair, secondary region pair. And what is this benefit of? What is the benefit you should get when you talk about this one? The benefit is, first one, let's look into this one. We are saying that, remember, each data center, they are trying to keep it at least 300 mile away so that it cannot be impacted to each other. So if one can impact it, it cannot go to impact another one. They are trying to keep the 300 mile, but probably in some countries or some region where they cannot, it may reduce, but they are ideally they want this one. The reason behind, if one region can impact it, another one can, because 300 means what, almost a 450 kilometer apart. Then you have a another option, which is known as platform provided replication, something like storage based replication or some services are replicating to each other. So you can get a benefit where your replication is happening within a region, from one region to another region, within a region, but from one region to another region. So it can be retrieve or access. What happened? If assume you are one of the region goes down, or there's a broad outage, probably the entire India is down. Then what they do? They always give a priority for the region which is a paired region, so that you can always get you try to access it from the regional pair location. So they give a priority of one of the region out of every pair region, so that you can able to access your application. In case you are not opted for the assume to your server running from one of the region, probably they are only access it from one of the region. It's not necessary you can get a both one at the same time, because they need to put all the resources to recover one of it. So you always get a priority from the all of the out of the two region pair or region pair. They should try to access, or they need to up and or resolve the issues from one of the region pairs, so that you can start accessing it. Another important thing is update. Whenever they are rolling out the update, like patches or some firmware. So what they do, they first roll out into the one region, so that once one region get completed, then they go for the second region of part of the same region pair, so that your services may not be impacted at the same time. They go in a sequential manner. Another one with respect to data residency. Remember, a region resides within the same geography. With respect to tax and law enforcement requirement, so that your data may remain into the India. Let's assume you don't want your data should go out of India. Take example of Aadhaar card. Then it will remain in India. Probably one data center in Mumbai, another is in Chennai. Your data remain in their same region. It is not going beyond that. You are able to use the cloud services, and your data may be in the same bound, is not crossing the boundary, and you also get an feature of the high availability, because if one goes down, you're able to access from the second region. This is known as region pair benefit. Now, the another one which is known as Azure Availability Zone, this is a new services. I cannot say new service, it is a preview mode which is recently launched. This Azure Availability Zone is the concept which is already exists into the AWS. So AWS basically already have this concept known as availability zone, but this concept was not part of the Azure earlier, which is recently started. So as on date, this Azure availability zone is only offered into the two of the region known as East US 2 and West Europe, not in all the regions. So if you talk about 36 region out of 36, they are just offering in two region, not everywhere. Now, what is this region availability zone? The availability zone is actually assume they have a one data center in Mumbai. Then what they did, they've created another data center in Mumbai, but are quite far apart. Probably one is in East South Mumbai, another is West Mumbai, both have a different one. So if in a regional, at a city level, if there is a problem in one of the data center, you can still able to access your services from the another data center, which is hosted into the another, on the same location from the other data center. So within a region, they have a different data center. And this data center is in have basically their own, they're an independent data center. They are not connected to each other with respect to the facility. Both are independent. They have their own cooling or networking or power one. But they are connected with each other in the region. Assume at least in a region, they must have the three availability zone or three data center, I can say that. So that, and these three regions or three data center are connected into the same with a high bandwidth connectivity. So assume this is the Mumbai region, and in the Mumbai region they have a three data center. One is north, one is south, one other is say East Mumbai. Both are all are connected to each other. If one of the region goes down, you are able to still access your services because other two data center is up and running. So this data center which you're talking about, we call them as availability zone. So what you can do, probably you can host your services in one of the availability zone, probably one, you can create a replica in two and three. So if your one goes down, you're still able to access your services from the other data center, maybe two or third data center. Remember, I just told you this is currently offered into the two regions only, East US 2 or West Europe only. In each availability zone or in each region, we have a data center. Whenever you are hosting any services, basically you are hosting in one of the data center, and the data center is what? Is where your servers is there, servers and storage boxes are there, which where you are actually hosting your services. Remember, this data center are divided into clusters, and these clusters is nothing but in a group of the data center. So what happened in a availability zone, you may have a, they have created one data center where you can just, they have a 5,000 or 8,000 or 10,000 server, then they created another data center which is adjacent to it. I'm not talking about the availability zone here. I'm just talking about the data centers. Let me take you to the whiteboard. Assume this is one of the region. In this region, you may have a availability zone. In this availability zone, you have a multiple data center, which is, because one data center may be a 5,000 to 8,000 servers. This is a concept of the AWS also, same concept. And where actually your services are hosted. So this is actually your services are hosted in this data center. So the cluster is nothing but in a cluster of the, like you have a rack or you have a cluster server. So if enough server, you have a multiple server, like cluster is a normal term which you use into the infrastructure services, multiple servers. If one of the server goes down, you're able still able to access your services from the another server. So you have two node cluster or three node or four node cluster, you're still able to do it. In cluster, you have a thousands of servers, and probably if one goes down, you're still able to access the services from the another server. Then we have another term known as fault domain and the upgrade domain. Azure called, assume they have a, in data center, they have a three rack. Rack one, rack two, and rack three. Azure called this one of the rack as a fault domain. So in the fault domain, if you assume your if your entire rack goes down, then your services will be impacted, which is known as single point of failure. So they call this a fault domain, and the fault domain is basically a group of machine which is connected with a single source and network switch. So assume this rack may have a this switch, this rack have a different switch, this rack have a different switch, or probably these servers have a connected to one of the power supply, which is your one of the power strip where all the servers are connected. And if this power, there's any impact to this service switch or this power strip, maybe your entire rack will be down. And we call this a fault domain. Remember, in availability set, which we talk about to the later slide, whenever you configure the availability set, your server will by default host in a two different fault domains, in fault domain 0 and fault domain 1 or 2, so that if one of the server goes down, assume here you are creating a load balancing. In a load balancing, one of the server may be in fault domain 1, another one in fault domain 2. If one of the server goes down or your one of the rack goes down, you're still able to access your services from the another fault domain, which is another rack. Remember, you cannot control which fault domain you can choose. This is taken care by Azure itself, and then they can actually allocate it internally. The another term which is known as upgrade domain. The upgrade domain is basically is a logical unit of deployment which is used by the Azure and they can use it for the purpose of patching. So whenever you distribute your instances, you launch your instance, they launch an instance, or you launch one more than one instance, they ensure that your instance should be in different upgrade domain. So assume there's a set of servers. Let's take this example. assume I have a one rack here. I have another rack. Then I have a say servers here. Assume I am, and this is a fault domain, which is your rack. The first concept is assume you are launching your instance. You want your instance should be in a load balancing environment so that once goes down, second will take care. So Azure will ensure that your one of the server may be here, first may be here, second may be here. So if this fault domain goes down, one of the fault domain, which is a rack, at the rack level, if goes down, you're still able to access from the another rack. So fault domain, nothing but a rack. This is a concept one. Another concept is, now they want to do the patching. What if they, probably they have all the, services running from this server and this server. Because they have thousands of servers, if they start the patching for both the server at the same time, then there what is the use of the fault domain, because your server may be impacted at the same time. So what they do, they created a upgrade domain. They say that, let's assume, just for example, this is my one of the upgrade domain. This is my one of the another upgrade domain. So what will happen? They ensure that if your server must be also in different upgrade domain. So when they do the patching, they will do the patching for first of this upgrade domain. When they complete this upgrade domain patching, then they will go to the second upgrade domain, which is a upgrade domain 2, to do the patching. This will help you to ensure your server must be up and running for a, and you get a high availability. This is known as your fault domain. So let's take an example. Assume you have a five instances. We just talk about it will be starting from 5 to 20. Default is 5. So if you have 5 instances, they allocate your one instance into each upgrade domain. You have a cluster where you have a 5 instance. If you have a 2, they can divide into a 2 to each. If they have a 3, they have a 10, they can divide. If they have 14, probably one, 4 can get a 3, 1 can get a 2. If you want to change this scenario where you want that you have a 10 instance, it should be in 10 upgrade domain, then you need to change the setting so that your each instance must be in one different upgrade or 10 different upgrade domains. You can go up to a 20. Remember, you cannot choose it. It can be again taken care by a internal system where you don't have a control. Then we call the concept as the availability set. This availability set is the same concept which we just talked about. Whenever you use this availability set, you actually use the option of fault domain, so you're ensuring that your server must be in two different fault domains. So when you launch an instance with respect to the availability set, when you configure the availability set and you're launching a two instances, system will ensure that your one instance should be in a fault domain 1, another in fault domain 2, so that if your one of the fault domain, which is a rack, goes down, you are able to access your services from the another rack. Remember, the Microsoft giving you an SLA of 99.95% only when your services are, when you are using this availability set. They are not going to give you an services if you are not using this availability set. Means if you are just using one server, and then it is assumed this is a rack one. Here your one server is hosted, not here. Only one server, they cannot give you a 99.95% service availability. They are giving you this services SLA only when you have you using this availability set and ensuring that your server must be in two different fault domains.